Hi everyone, this is Veronica and today we are going to discuss our program by ISRO, that is Unnati program. We'll discuss its features and details, and for my video updates you can follow me on Instagram and Facebook. The PDF of this lecture will be uploaded immediately on my Telegram channel, address of which is given in the end of the lecture. And this is a channel, StudyIQ. If you're preparing for any government exam, our pen drive and tablet courses are also available. For additional information, you can call on these numbers or you can visit our website. So here you can see the list of courses we have made. If you want any information about these courses, you can contact us on these numbers. So what is the relevance of this topic in the exam? So firstly, in your mains, if we talk from the UPSC perspective, mains paper 3, science and technology. So awareness in the fields of IT and space is very important. And at objective level, what is Unnati program? ISRO has initiated it. So what is the background behind it? It's very necessary. And at subjective level, you should have information about all the missions of the ISRO, because in UPSC prelims or any other exam, whatever the latest information you can get from the ISRO, what satellites are being launched and whatever extra information like the assisted technologies they are developing, you should have important knowledge about all the missions. You should have all the knowledge about it. And these are important for examination point of view. Now there's a question for you. You can attempt and comment in the comment section. Consider the following statements with respect to Unnati program. So first statement is, it is an initiative of the ISRO. It aims to train astronauts for the upcoming Chandrayaan missions. Now, which of the statements, above given statements, is correct or correct? So only one, only two, both one and two, neither one and two. So we'll discuss after the end of the lecture. I hope you will be able to answer this question. But if you know the answer right now, you can comment in the comment section. Now let's start. What is this Unnati program? So basically, it is a capacity building program on nano-satellite development. Now the word used here, nano-satellite, what is a nano-satellite? So like you use your mobiles, satellites are also getting smaller and better. So nanosatellites are those satellites that are just about the size of your shoebox, but they can almost do everything a conventional satellite does, and that too at a fraction of the cost. So which is why everybody, from government organizations and startups to educational institutes, they are scrambling to get a piece of small satellite pie, right? So to be clear here, not all small satellites, like we use the terms like small satellites, mini satellites, so you should know the difference between them. So to be clear at that end, let me tell you, not all the small satellites are well and small satellites, right? So a spacecraft that weighs between 100 to 500 kgs, 100 to 500 kgs, it is called as mini satellite. Okay, so if it weighs between 10 to 100 kgs, you can call it micro satellite. Now, a nano satellite mass range is between 1 kg to 10 kg, right? And if your spacecraft weighs between 100 grams and 1 kg, it would be called a pico satellite. So like that, we have even we can even make satellites and name them which even weigh less than 100 grams also, right? So here it is an initiative by ISRO to commemorate the 50th anniversary of the first United Nations conference on the exploration of peaceful uses of outer space, and they call it as UNispace 50. So now you should know the other things about this program. Like, this program provides opportunities to the participating developing countries so that they can strengthen in assembling, integrating and testing of nanosatellite. So here it is written that Unnati program, it is planned to be conducted for 3 years. So this is important. It will be conducted for your 3 years by URO Satellite Center for ISRO. So where is this URO Satellite for ISRO? It is in Bengaluru. So formerly it was known as ISRO Satellite Center, that is ISAC. And it is a lead center for building satellites and developing associated satellite technologies. So it is named before a scientist who died in 2013. He was a very renowned scientist, Uduppi Ramachandran Rao, right? So it will, this Inakti program will be held in 3 batches and it will target to benefit officials of 45 countries. So the first batch of this program has started on 17th Jan 2019, this year only, with 30 participants from 17 countries. So we had 30 participants from 17 countries. So the name of the countries you can or you cannot remember, it depends upon you. Like the countries which were involved were Algeria, Argentina, Azerbaijan, Bhutan, Brazil, Chile, Egypt, Indonesia, Kazakhstan, Malaysia, Mexico, Mongolia, Morocco, Myanmar, Oman, Panama and Portugal, right? So now we'll discuss about what is this UNispace 50. Okay, so see, it is basically an event marking of 50th year of the first UN conference on the exploration of peaceful. So how we can use this satellite system for the peaceful uses of outer space? So we are marking the 50th anniversary for that. This initiative was started by United Nations Office for Outer Space Affairs. You can see here, so this is important, who started this initiative of UNispace. So before this, 3 such conferences on that were also held, and they tried to recognize the potential of space and led guidelines for human activities also. Like there was UNispace 1 which was held in Vienna 1968. So it was held from 14th to 27. So this is written in red. Let me change the color of the pen so you can remember. Yeah, so I'll write it again. So this UNispace first conference was held from, no, it is not changed again. I'll try, but I think there's some problem. Anyway, let me write with this color only then. Okay, so this was held from 14th to 27th August 1968, and it was the first in the series of 3 global UN conferences on outer space, which focused on raising awareness for the vast potential of space benefits for all humankind. Next was UNispace 2nd. It was again held in Vienna 1982, and it was held from 9th to 21 August 1982. And this was to address the concerns of how to maintain the outer space for peaceful purposes and prevent an arms race in outer space. And third, UNispace 3rd was in 1999. It was like 19 to 30th of July 1999. So UNispace 3, it created a blueprint for the peaceful uses of outer space in 21st century. So this UNispace program, now you should understand, it is for the peaceful use of exploration of outer space, so that nobody uses it for arms exploration. This is the significance of this UNispace program. So now even ISRO is also building nano satellites. ISRO nano satellites, they are known as INS. It is a versatile and modular nano satellite bus system, and it is envisioned for the future science and experimental payloads. So there are only mainly 4 objectives of our INS. First is to design and develop a low cost modular nano satellite, and then to provide opportunity for ISRO technology demonstration and payloads, and to provide a standard bus for launch on demand services. So even these nano satellites will be used to provide an opportunity to carry innovative payloads for universities and research and development laboratories. So I hope I'm clear here. So here the answer is only one. That means statement one is right, that it is an initiative of the ISRO. It aims to train astronauts for upcoming Chandrayaan. No, it is a nano satellite development program. So here only one is the correct answer. If you have any queries, you can contact me on social media, and the PDF of this lecture will be uploaded on my Telegram channel. Thank you.